Well, the government's asylum seeker swap with Malaysia has certainly been a success for 13 people. They arrived in Melbourne yesterday to start their new lives here. But with the other half of the deal awaiting a High Court ruling, Papua New Guinea has come to the rescue of the Gillard government, agreeing to host asylum seekers on Manus Island. Now, the opposition's immigration spokesman, Scott Morrison, believes even that won't save the government. I spoke to him a short time ago. Mr. Morrison, thanks for your time. Do you have any objection at this point to Manus Island as an option?
Well, I believe it when I see it. I mean, Manus Island was part of the Pacific Solution that the coalition previously operated. Our preference is obviously for Nauru for two very important reasons. One is there are not the same disease risks on Nauru that there are on Manus Island. And secondly, Nauru operates as an open centre. People aren't kept behind the fence. They can move around the island freely, and it's not clear that that option is available on Manus Island.
But do you have an issue with Manus Island? There's nothing, no evidence, as far as I'm aware, that it couldn't work.
Well, it certainly worked when we were operating it. Whether this government can make things work, I think, is a question everybody has. But, I mean, I think there's still some time away from this. I mean, the minister says weeks. Last time he said that, what he was talking about, the Malaysian deal took months. I'm not going to hold my breath about this. We don't have any in principle objections. We do think Nauru is the better option if you're going to open somewhere. And given that they've been open and available to doing this for a year at least, it's puzzling that the government has chosen not to take up that option.
If asylum seekers are sent successfully by this government to either Manus Island or to Malaysia, if you then win government, will you then shut down those options even if the people smuggling trade has been reduced by those actions?
Well, frankly, I think there are just too many hypotheticals in this question. I mean, this deal is almost, it's more than a quarter exhausted within just 2 weeks of it being signed. So, frankly, I just don't think the deal will still be there. But in terms of Manus Island, we have no issue with Manus being used as a facility for offshore processing. Our preference is to go to Nauru. We think it's a better option. But when we're in government, we operated both facilities.
But this is an important question. If there are refugees in Malaysia under this swap deal, and you come into power, would you then cancel that deal and take the 800 back, or would you leave them there?
Well, the deal will be exhausted. It will be completed. The people who have been sent there will already be there.
Yeah, but the Australian government has committed to paying for them whilst they're there. Would you continue those payments, or would you cease them?
Well, the Australian government is only committed to make a one-off payment on the transfer of each person. I think there's some confusion about this. The government is only making one payment and a per capita basis, and that's my understanding of the arrangement. So I think this idea, I mean, and it's around about 90,000 or thereabouts per person across all the various agencies that are involved here. When or if we're able to form a government, I think this Malaysian agreement will be well and truly exhausted.
So you would leave those individuals in Malaysia and you would have no further obligations to their welfare or safety?
Well, answer me this. Where on earth would they be? I mean, one of the big problems with this arrangement is people will just basically disappear. I mean, who knows if those same people won't turn up on another boat to Australia at some point. I mean, the government has put their policy in place. They'll be held to account for their policies. The coalition will be held to account for ours.
Scott Morrison, thanks very much for your time.
Thanks very much.